I knew this was coming. There were warnings.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into CrushTheStreet.com. I am Kenneth Amaduri, and today we are going to start our discussion with Bitcoin. Bitcoin's nightmare scenario has come to pass, and it's come to pass this week. Now, following in the ripple effects of Mike Hearn's and what we're calling exaggerated Bitcoin is dead type disclosure, Bitcoin has seen some turmoil caused by the current block size cap of 1 megabyte. And this is coming to pass. We're seeing this now. The problem is a backlog of transactions, increasing confirmation times for sending Bitcoin with standard recommended fees up to multiple hours. The average confirmation time this week ballooned from 10 minutes to 43 minutes. And those that were ignorant to the need to increase transfer fees were left dazed and confused. This slowdown even affected businesses, causing some minor commerce disruptions from the delays. Days ago, there was a backlog of over 30,000 transactions unconfirmed. This has been reduced to 15,000 here Thursday morning. Now remember, the block reward halving is happening in approximately 4 months. So we believe a lot of loss of the miner reward is already priced into Bitcoin, but there will certainly be repercussions in a higher per Bitcoin price into June, July, and August. And of course, this is some speculation. So be sure to call us out on this if I am wrong here in the future. Shifting gears from Bitcoin to fiat currency problems, namely the US dollar, let's start, take a look at Iran. Iran, we had the Iran nuclear deal go through, sanctions were lifted, the Iranian economy had been just completely handicapped for this time. And now the economy, the people there, they want to start making money. And they got their eyes set on different parts of the world. And now they're trading with Brazil. Now, Brazil is converting from their dealings in US dollars with Iran to now euros. And again, this is another axe to the leg of the US dollar, another haircut for the US dollar. I'm not going to say it's the final nail in the coffin for the US dollar, but we know that the dollar is on a decline in terms of its conventional safe haven aspect and where its position is around the world. Now, more than 20 countries no longer trade in solely US dollars. These countries account for 60% of GDP. And we warned about the ongoing death of the US dollar back in 2014 with our documentary. And if you missed it, you definitely need to check it out. Now, $30 oil is a problem for a lot of these one-trick pony countries who depend on the export of petroleum for their country to even function, and Venezuela is a prime example of that. They've suffered greatly from the fall in oil, and recent news just came out that the Venezuelan president raises fuel prices by 6,000% to prop up their falling economy and currency crisis. Low oil prices are good for people, but when you have a country that's dependent on it to a very large extent, there are other equal and worse off consequences of having cheap oil. And we are seeing that happen around the world. The economic crisis continues. So let's talk precious metals. Gold is continuing its 2016 rally here into March. We are at $1,256.88, up over 1% for the day, continuing to have that confirmation of bull market trajectory here in 2016. Silver, which has actually been lagging gold, is over $15. Today we're looking at it at $15.12. Again, this is up over 1% for the day. Now, earlier this week, we were actually watching silver under $15. And I know that was a psychological threshold. Silver has been lagging gold. And we actually have an interview being released this weekend with Craig Hemke, where we discuss why silver has been lagging and what is going on with precious metals. So you're not going to want to miss this important update regarding precious metals. So this story that was just released by Zero Hedge, really interesting. Canada, regarding precious metals, Canada has sold off all of its gold reserves. Now, not all of its gold reserves, but almost all of it. And they've been selling their gold reserves since the mid-1960s. They had 1,000 tons of gold in the mid-1960s. And by 1985, they had sold about half of it. And from 2002, or the 1990s to 2002, they almost sold everything else. So last year, they had 3 tons of gold left. So from 1,000 down to 3. And then this year, they are down to 1.7 tons of gold left. So nearly selling everything. And right now, their gold asset makes up 0.1% of the country's total reserves, which include foreign currency deposits and bonds. Now, apparently, the country thinks this is a good idea to continue selling gold because now they can focus on purchasing better assets. And again, this is quoting their leaders here. The government's decision to dump gold was wise and astute, and we are definitely going to be watching this and seeing if this really is a wise and astute decision. And we're seeing this shift from real money, real assets, into financialized assets. And we have talked about this, how there is going to be a transfer from financialized assets such as paper assets, stocks and bonds, to real money, and that is, in our opinion, precious metals. And I think that's going to happen. And a lot of these countries and the paper world, I'll call it, will see this come to pass. And you know what? I do want to hold precious metals, especially in this time, not just because it's going up now here in 2016. I can almost care less about the small move we've seen. These are good prices to accumulate something that is going to hold its value. And not only that, just, you know, when the financialized assets lose their value, it's going to shift. There's going to be a transfer of that wealth. And if you can own and be positioned to where that transfer is going to go, you are going to be sitting in great shape. So that's my report today, everyone. I'm Kenneth Amadori. Thank you so much for listening. I appreciate the comments. I appreciate the feedback and the conversation because, you know, we're all in this together. We're learning from one another, and it's just been a great experience doing this research and sharing important information with all of you. Thank you so much, and I'll be talking with you soon.